So I would like to appreciate the organizer to add my talk today. And so my this talk is done by collaboration with Bill and Kae, and we are also discussing with Yasa, Bruno, and Esteban. So we are hoping that to have a collaboration with them also in the future. So this is the last talk today, and maybe you are very tired. So let me talk about my this final goal of this study. So I think all of the people know this movie. And this is called Back to the Future 2. And in the first series, this car is called DeLorean. And this DeLorean was moved by a nuclear plant. But in the second movie, the dog scientist moved this DeLorean with the garbage. And so this study, final goal is to consider to downsize of this, to have a fuel to move something. So downsizing to nanoscale is a final goal, but this study is only the starting point. So now let me talk about so to transport energy in nanoscale, we consider that the excitation from the input to the output during that environmental effect is an obstacle. That is common sense, I think. But in some biological system, doing the opposite way, namely the biological system called the photosynthetic system in photosynthetic bacteria uses environmental effect, so-called noise, to transport energy. So, but to mimic the biological system is very, very complicated. So Bill and Kai and I consider to go another way to use the noise, actively applying noise to transport energy. That is an idea of this study. But let me start from a very simple model like this linear chain. And let me consider this very simple model, so three-site model, and the excitation energy is different, and there is a most nearest neighbor interaction between these. And we have a terminal, at the terminal we have trap. So the decay rate is kappa. So now we consider to apply noise to the excitation level. And if the difference between the excitation level becomes smaller, the transition becomes easier. But when the noise is applied in this way, the noise can decrease the energy difference between the sites. So in that case, the noise can accelerate the energy transport. So we are considering to apply the noise to this excitation level, but here we are considering to apply the spatial noise with spatial temporal correlations. So in the Hamiltonian, the noise is applied to the diagonal term, and the unperturbed Hamiltonian has the most nearest neighbor interaction. Oh, thank you. Thank you. So here is a noise in the Hamiltonian. This is a stochastic noise. And so in the original model, this stochastic noise was considered to be white noise. So it means that the correlation time is infinitely short, or zero. But here we consider to extend the noise to include the temporal correlation and spatial correlation. Now let me talk about such a spatial temporal correlation in more detail. So this correlation is described with the noise correlation function like this. And here, temporal correlation we describe as exponential decay. And the spatial correlation is described with this coefficient. And usually this coefficient is considered to be a positive number from 0 to 1, but here we consider to this coefficient extend to negative region. So this negative region correlation we call anti-correlation. So now let me talk about the anti-correlation in more detail. So if the noises applied to these two sides has the anti-correlation, what happens? So if the noise applied to the first side is decrease the excitation energy, if the anti-correlated noise is applied to the second side, the noise increase the excitation energy of the second side. So the, if the applied noise has the opposite sign, this is called the anti-correlated, anti-spatially correlated noise. So if the energy difference is like this, anti-correlation can decrease the energy difference. So this kind of noise can accelerate the energy transport. So for this model, by using the time convolutionless type of master equation, we can have the time depend time evolution of this system after averaging out the noise. So, but when so to be started, let me talk about the two-side model. Only the two-side is included in the system, and for this system, we have this four simultaneous differential equation. And this is a very simple one, and we can numerically solve this time convolutionless type of master equation. But it is a little bit complicated, so let me show you the more simplified master equation. So by making the element of the four element to be the element of this vector, the master equation is described as this, and GT is called the supermatrix. And GT includes these four kinds of correlation function. And F1 means the correlation of noise applied to the first side. And F2 means the correlation function of noise applied to the second side. So usually we use only these two terms. But we found that the other two terms are originally exist in this supermatrix, so that is F1, F2, and F2, F1 type of correlation. And this means that the spatial correlation can be included, is originally included in the master equation, and this correlation function has a negative sign. So if this correlation has an anti-correlation and this correlation function is negative, totally this becomes positive and it accelerates the decay of the master, of the relevant system. So that is the analytic side of explanation of the acceleration of energy transport by anti-spatially correlated noise. So now let me show you the numerical evaluation of this model. And so here we consider the two-side model. And at the initial time, first side is fully excited, and the second side is vacant at the initial time. And this graph shows the time evolution of second side. And so this starts from the zero and goes higher, becomes, has a peak and a decay after that. And the left graph shows a spatially uncorrelated noise case, and the right graph shows the anti-correlated spatial noise case. And Here we use the scale parameter as a noise strength, and we also introduce the parameter, dimensionless parameter alpha, which is a multiplication of noise strength and correlation time. And we use the delta as a scaling parameter. Changing alpha means the changing correlation time of noise. And we change the alpha from 0.1 to 10, and we found that it has a peak, and after that it decays. And if the peak becomes higher, the transport finishes faster. And when we compare this graph with the anti-correlated case, the peak is about 40% increase, so we can improve the energy transport by anti-correlated noise. So to find such a feature in more detail, we evaluate the elapsed time of transport. And the vertical axis shows the time of elapsed time of transport, and the horizontal axis is a degree of spatial correlation. And changing alpha, we found that all of these curves shows the degrees as the degree of spatial correlation to become minus one. Minus one means the anti-correlated spatial noise, spatially correlated noise. So we can find that all of the temporally correlated noise, we can find that spatially anti-correlated noise can decrease the time for transport, means can accelerate the transport. And for the temporal correlation, we find that some optimum point is between alpha is equal to 1 to 10. But here we can find that this feature shows us that we can control the energy transport by choosing the feature of noise correlation. So now let me talk about the three-site model case. And in this case, we can find that the spatial correlation can also change the transport feature. And this left one is a spatially uncorrelated case, and the central one is anti-correlated between one site 1 to 2 and site 2 to 3, which we call the anti-ferromagnetic case. And the third one is anti-correlated from between site 1 to 2 and site 1 to 3. And for these, we can find a different feature. And the central anti-ferromagnetic case is the best one. So now let me show you more detail the feature of elapsed time of transport dependence on the coefficient of spatial correlation. The horizontal axis shows the coefficient, spatial correlation of coefficient between site 2 and 3, and the vertical axis shows the spatial correlation coefficient between site 1 and 2. And the spatially uncorrelated case is corresponds to this central one. And here, in this graph, the violet region shows the fast transport case, and the red region shows the slow transport case. And the spatially uncorrelated case is the central and medium case, but the anti-ferromagnetic spatially correlated noise is here, so this means the fastest transport. And the anti-correlation between site 1 and 2 and site 1 and 3 exists here, and this is not so good, has a not so short transport time. So we can find that in this linear chain model, we can change the transport time by changing the spatial correlation. So let me talk about a little bit more extension of this model to the triangle case. So we put the three sides in this triangle and changing the excitation energy and the spatial correlation. And so here we put input to the site one and output to the site three. So this means a single input and a single output case. So for this model, I try to find, so the computer is not so fast. So I tried to find a master equation like the two-sided model, and I put the trap decay to the third side at the first time. But here we found that the negative population for this case. So it was very trouble for me, and the master equation can negative population have a negative population is a very first case for me. So we considered to make another direction. So to find this, when I found the negative population, I obtain the master equation by interacting trap with only the site three. This makes the negative population. But when I tried to trap interact only site three, but if we include the site one, two, three interaction also, we can find the master equation doesn't show the negative population. So this also occurs maybe in the quantum hybrid system also. And in many cases, light system and the matter system interact, but the light system generator or cavity decay is described with only the light one, and the matter decay is generator described only the matter one, and we add this one in the master equation. But when the light and the matter interact strongly or immediately strongly interact, we have to include all of these systems to obtain the master equation. So including this point, I made a calculation about residence time at each site. And for changing a spatial correlation for four types. And the first one is a spatial correlation is uncorrelated between each site. And the second one is positively correlated site between site one and two, and the other one are anti-correlated. And we have two more cases as a similar spatially correlated one. But we can find the residence time evaluation for changing the excitation energy for site two and site three, with keeping the excitation energy of site one with 2B1. We found a very different feature for different dependence on the excitation energy. So let me show you the dynamics of the center point. It means the excitation energy for three sites is the same. And changing spatial correlation, we found that the dynamics of each site and including the output trap site, we found the spatial correlation can change the dynamics. And especially in the on the site two, we found that the red line, this means this kind of spatial correlation, stops the excitation to the second site a very long time. And other case, we can find that the spatial correlation can be switched off. So we found that many various dependence of spatial correlation for this model. So we would like to extend this study to more complicated network or a more specificated or a more clear physical model and try to find that this car. So this going back to from this car going to from 1895 to 2015. So 4 years ago, this had to come, but this car doesn't come. So I hope that this study can have a clue to this car will come in near future. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. About noise and car industry.
Thank you. Can I just ask you to go into a bit more detail about why you're seeing negative populations in the master equation? Is that specific? Is that because of the negative correlations you're putting in, or was it? Would I expect for any sort of a triangular structure to run into that problem? Like, what was the issue there?
So I cannot have your question. So would you tell me your question more concretely?
Sure. I was just asking. Can you go into restate why you were having trouble with negative populations in your master equation?
So I think negative population case, I considered only the interaction between site 3 and trap site. But after we include all of these interaction to find the generator of the trap, the negative population disappear.
Okay, and you mentioned in the following slides that was because you had, because of strong interactions?
This one.
Okay. Okay, thanks. That's all.
Okay. So quantum hybrid system is also this kind of problem, I think.
I have a very dumb question, but it's out of curiosity. So in one of the graphs, actually many of the graphs you show of your dynamics, you have some secondary oscillation. Mm-hmm. Where that oscillation comes from?
Oscillation, yes. That is a very good question. So oscillation comes by the exchange of energy between the other side. So in this case, we are considering the non-Markovian effect. In that case, the noise has a finite correlation time. So it has a memory of noise. So such a memory makes this kind of oscillation.